Hi, welcome back to my channel. I'm Miss Lisa, and today I'm going to be reviewing the Safe Pac Venture Safe Pac EXP45 anti-theft carry-on travel bag.
That was a handful.
So I have had this bag for about a year now. I've used it a couple of times, but the one time I used it was 2 months in Europe. And I'll show you all the benefits and features, pros and cons, and help you decide if you get this bag or not. Let's get to it. I guess I'll talk about the features that made me decide to get this bag over other bags. One of the reasons is because the bag opens up like a luggage. So what I mean by that is a lot of the other backpacks, they open from the top, so you have to like reach in and mess up everything to get what you need at the very bottom. But this one, when you open it, it turns out I still have clothes in here. But when you open it, you see everything you need. So it opens up like a suitcase. So another factor that I really liked was that it had a hip belt right here. So then all the weight isn't on your shoulders, which hurts a lot if you have ever had a heavy backpack. So most of the weight I pretty much distribute onto my waist. The bag itself is about 3 pounds when it's empty. Another great thing is that this bag is the size for a typical carry-on luggage. So you don't have to pay for extra fees to check in your baggage, which is great. And you don't have to worry about your stuff getting lost because it'll be on you on the flight and you'll always have a visual of it. And another factor was that it had a water bottle holder. For the longest time, I didn't know that this part unbuttoned. So I was like struggling for the longest time. I'm like, why is it so tiny? As I showed you earlier, you could carry it as like a briefcase, or you could wear it as a backpack with these two straps. And if you want to put these two straps away, you can. You just unbuckle it here, and then you tuck it into the slot right here. Except I never do that because it's a struggle trying to get this in there and tucked away. And plus I always use it as a backpack because I just hate carrying things. And I like how the bag is very simple. I bought it for about $230 for this bag. And it was $50 cheaper than the black ones. And then these are other benefits that the bag includes that I didn't really care about, but it was good to have. So the product is slash proof. So you can take a knife and cut it and it'll be fine, but I'm not gonna do that because I'm not trying to destroy my bag. And it has a double lock mechanism. So right here, you just unlock it by pulling it and then you pull it apart. And then also you slide it to unlock it and voila. Same goes with here. You pull it down, slide it to unlock, and you got it here. It came with a cable, which I don't know if I put it away. Okay, it turns out I took away the cable, but it comes with this metal cable that you can kind of attach it to the wall or a chair that's bolted to the ground, which I don't have. I'll show you an image of it. And then in here, it has different compartments for separating your electronics and stuff like that. A small pocket here, a laptop pocket in here, a pencil pocket, two more small pockets. I don't know why I have tissues, but I guess it's great. And I have hand wipes in here that I left for my trip. And then a giant pocket here, a deep middle pocket, and a small little pocket there. And yes, it does get bulky when you do fill it up, so then over here it kind of poofs up. It makes it harder for anyone trying to steal from you, I guess, from your bag, because they're not getting anywhere in your bag because it's all clipped up and locked away. Also, another thing that they mentioned is that it's puncture. So I don't know if you guys ever seen it, but when people could stick their pens in here and it'll just open up. I'm not gonna try that because I don't wanna ruin this bag, but it seems like it's very thick. Right here, I'll show you. Very thick and good hardware. So it's quite strong and durable, I would feel. And what's good about this top part here is that you could put a jacket or some shoes and hang it off of here, or even put a yoga mat and then tighten it so then it doesn't go anywhere. So I randomly have a yoga mat and I'm just gonna attach it to the top here. Get it attach it, tighten it, and this yoga mat is not going anywhere. Voila. So I usually stick my jacket up in here and my shoes because I don't want it to stink up my whole bag. Alright, time for the cons of this bag. So the only thing I could think of when I was using it for the whole year is that I wish this water bottle pocket was much larger. It is a bit tight, even when you extend that button there. I wish it has like maybe one or two external pockets, because as you can see, the only way that you're getting something out of your bag is if you unbuckle this and you undo this and then you zip your bag, which is quite frustrating if you have to get in and out of your bags to get something. I do have another bag. I usually have a smaller backpack, but still, like, say if I only wanted to travel with this, it does get quite annoying. Like, maybe they could have put a small pocket here, that would have been great, or even one on the strap, that would have been awesome. But just like minor details, I feel. No deal breakers. And then also, this isn't waterproof. It is, I would say, water resistant. So if it rains a lot, your stuff are getting soaked inside of here. Quite annoying. I wish it came with a backpack cover. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope I helped you distinguish if you want to buy it or not. Like, comment, and subscribe, and ring that notification button. Until next time, peace. I do love this bag a lot. Like, it's quite comfy to lay on because a lot of times I slept at the airport and this was a nice cushiony pillow. Bye. Oi.